Hello everyone, in this video we will be discussing a 1D bar problem. So what is the aim of the experiment is, consider a bar shown below, determine nodal displacement, stress in each element, reaction forces and compare the theoretical results with the analytical values. Given E1 value, E2 value, E3 value as 70, 105 and 200 GPa respectively. The length of the each element is also defined very clearly in the problem. And see the left hand corner and right hand corner, it is fixed in all DOF. At node 2 and node 3, there is a point load of 20 kN and 10 kN load is applied in y direction. We will see how to solve this problem by using ANSYS. So, select the structural discipline in preference, give OK, go to preprocessor, element type, add, edit, delete, add, link. We have three different material, so go with three reference numbers. So, three reference number you select off. Then go to the real constant. So, first let me define for the first set area, which is nothing but 900. Initial strain is 0. Okay. Next, for the set 2, the area is 400. Since it is a static load, the initial strain is also 0. Next, for the set 3, the area is 200 and the initial strain is also 0. Give OK. Close this. Now go to the material properties, material models, structural, linear, elastic, isotropic for the first set. The Young's modulus for the first set is 0.7. E power 5 and Poisson's ratio is 0.22. Give OK. Now for second material, go to the new model, define material 2 and enter the value. The Young's modulus is 105 E power 3 E power 3 and the Poisson's ratio is 0.24. For the third material, the Young's modulus is 200 e power 3 and the Poisson's ratio is 0.3. Give OK. We can close this. Now go to the modeling, select nodes in active CS. For the node 1, it is 0,0, give apply. Then for node 2, it is 85,0, apply. For node 3, it is 180, apply. For node 4, it is 255. Give OK. Now we need to create the elements. Before that, we need to go to element attributes and make sure that the respective sets we are defining it properly. So through nodes for the node 1. Now element attributes for the link 2. Material set 2, real constant set 2, give OK. Now through nodes, give OK. Now element attributes, link 3, material number 3, real constant number 3, give OK. Auto number through node, select node 3 and node 4, give OK. We can able to see the different colors which indicates different elements. Now for boundary conditions, load, apply structural displacements on nodes. Node 1 and node 4 is fixed in all DOF. Select all DOF and give OK. Now go to the force moment on nodes. Pick node 2, apply FX direction. The value is 20 kN. So 20 into 10 power 3, apply. Similarly at node 3 and 10 kN. So 10 in positive direction. So we can move to the solution, solve current load step. Okay, so we got a note. Now how to view the result? Go to general post processor, list results, nodal solution, degrees of freedom solution, x component, displacement. Here we can able to see, since node 1 and node 4 is fixed, the deflection is 0. At node 2 and node 3, the values we can able to see. And similarly, the reaction, let it be all items, we can able to see the reactions at node 1 and node 4 since it is fixed. How to see the element stresses? Go to the element table, define table, add by sequence number, select LS1 as the code to check the line element stress. Go to the plot results, contour plot, line element stress, give OK. We can able to see the stress levels. If you are changing the values for the same problem, we will get the different again results. Do check with the different numbers, and if you get any doubts related to this problem, post your doubts in the comment section. Thank you.